So after a long time, DotOS is here for the Mi 12 devices, Redmi Note 9S, 9 Pro, Pro Max, Poco M2 Pro. This is DotOS V5.2. If you don't know, this is one of the unique custom ROMs out there, especially this update, which is DotOS V5.2, is just one of the great ones out there in the terms of UI changes. They have improved a lot. They already got you Android 12 UI. Yes, Android 12 is also released, so we're gonna expect Android 12 based ROMs very soon. It is based on Android 11, it's not Android version 12. Its Swiss kernel is pre-installed as we just saw, and we are talking about the DotOS V5.2, a Mi 12 version, which can be installed on Note 9S, Redmi Note 9 Pro, Pro Max, and Poco M2 Pro. Let's find out some things which you get in DotOS latest version, as it comes with the Pixel Launcher pre-installed. This is the official version, so the things you get in all the DotOS V5.2 update things almost kind of same, because this is official build, this is not unofficial build, no changes. If you want to take a look at all those features, the 6.9 DotOS V5.2, I made a dedicated specific video already on my channel, and you can go and check out that. We're just gonna talk about some device specific things here, as the things are working perfectly fine, as you can see, location, etc. And the quick send panel is almost same like the Android 12, not actually same like, but the edit and reset and these buttons are inspired from Android 12 quick settings panel. Everything else is just kind of same in my opinion. I think so this ROM is quite good. The default camera is Google Camera Go Edition, which you get pre-installed. Google Camera Go Edition is, I think, so far better than the normal Snap camera, which is not so good at all. It's up to you. If you like this, you can use it. If you don't like it, you can simply use other cameras out there. And other camera, which I mean, you can try out the ANX camera, which is basically a MIUI camera port. We're gonna talk about that. And this Google Camera Go Edition, this is the old edition, by the way, old update. The new update includes some extra features, HDR Plus, etc. I made a video on my Hindi channel, so make sure to check out that if you want to check out the new Google Camera Go Edition video. Here we have the ANX camera already. I have tried that. You can install the ANX camera version V190, and if you don't know how to install that, as always, that video is also available. You can search for it, you will find it very easily. ANX camera is working perfectly fine, portrait, video mode, everything was working fine. I didn't got any kind of bug. So yes, if you are not a lover of Google Camera Go Edition and if you want to try something else, you can try out this. Even if you don't want to install the ANX camera, you can use the Google camera. The Google camera 8.1, 2, 3, whatever you want to install, you can. All the Google camera videos are already present on my Hindi channel. Now let's just talk about the safety net status, or if you want to root your device with Magisk latest version. I've installed the Magisk 23, the latest version while making this video is Magisk 20, this is the version 23. The safety net status, as expectedly, does not have any kind of issues. If you want to use the banking apps, you can use. If you don't want to root your device, you'll still be able to use the banking apps, because safety net status is passing by default. Xiaomi parts is also included in this one. Xiaomi parts include some extra things. Xiaomi Doors, ambient display gestures, FPS info overlay, Mi sound enhancer, etc. Things are already included in this build. So yes, if you're looking for this one, yes, it's there. If you are a user who use Xiaomi parts on their devices, then you might like this one. Now in the terms of security section, as expectedly, fingerprint, face unlock, everything is present here for you. And if you're looking for app locker, that's also present in the DotOS customization section. If you want to check it out, that you can, it's up to you. Now let's just talk about the battery backup. In my case, I was not expecting this, but battery backup is not so good. Yes, I tried this, the performance is okay, and yes, if you want to compare it with the previous ROMs, WaveOS or DubFest OS, those ROMs are quite good enough. DotOS has unique UI, but unfortunately, the battery backup is not so good. As you can see, I've charged it till 100%. It's 32% left, and the screen on time which I got is 5 hours. So 5 hours at 32% left, which means approximately more than 10 to 11% of active drainage per hour, which is, I think, so more than enough. So in my thinking, the battery backup is not so good. Customizations, etc., like that you have the latest Android 12 gaming dashboard, which you can customize, which you can use it on your device. Some other customizations include some cool Android 12 style wallpaper customizations, etc. If you want to install this build, link is in the description, and already made a video on customizations. You can check out that one also. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and share this video. Goodbye. See you in the next video.
like I'm floating through the air.